which is a one of my first ever Halloween makeup. Like I said, it's very messy, but at the end of the day, this look is basically more of a glam, but also scary, if that makes sense. Anyways, but yeah, this is what I came up with. And you guys can see the highlights. So like I said, it's like a glam and it has glitter. And yeah, the makeup right here, like I said, it looks freaking first when you guys see the video. But once you start like applying everything out, it all comes together. And I just added this last minute just because I think it actually emphasizes the look a little more. And I just did some buns, messy buns, because like this glam is basically like just like a girl that's dead but still wants to look glam, if that makes any sense. And it's very messy, like I said, it's supposed to be messy, it's supposed to be the way it looks, that's how it looks. And I don't know where the hell I got this from, it just popped out of my head. And yeah, so this is what I came up with, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hello loves, welcome back to my channel. So let's go ahead and get started with this makeup tutorial. Okay, so first we are starting with my NYX HD Photogenic Concealer, and my shade is in CW05. So you're just gonna apply that, and I'm sorry, I was trying to see which was the best lighting, if it was off or on, but yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and put that all over our eyelid and just blend it out. Here I am taking the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores Press Powder and just applying that on my eyelid to set the concealer and just blend it out as I said. Next, we're going to be picking up my e.l.f. eyebrow pencil in dark brown, and we're just going to go ahead and carve our eyebrows just basically to define them and show that we have eyebrows. So like I said, this is a glam half dead look, so we have to have those brows very carved. And next we are gonna go ahead and use the e.l.f. eyebrow gel. Basically this, what this does is just basically set your eyebrows in place and just make them last longer. And yeah, and I'm just dancing random, okay weirdo. And here we are again. We're gonna go ahead and take my Beach Cosmetics palette in Smoky, and I'm taking the white one just to set all over my eyelid. And that's basically what I'm doing here, just setting my eyelid with just a plain white color. And I'm gonna go ahead and get a fluffy brush and just go into that dark black shade there and just put it in my crease and just bring it all the way to my inner corner. Like I said, it's kind of messy, and that's how it's supposed to be. So that is what we're doing. And the one thing you're going to be doing basically with this look is blending a lot. So don't forget to blend. Okay, so now here I'm using my Anastasia Beverly Hills palette in the self-made one. And I'm just taking the darkest shade that there is there, which you eventually will see. Like, it's so freaking dark. I didn't expect it to be this pigmented, but it is very, very pigmented, as you guys can see. And you know, just blend it out. Like I said, you're gonna have to blend, especially since it's black. You have to blend, girlfriend, blend for your life. And that is what I'm doing here. And right here I'm just taking the color Treasure and just putting that all over my eyelid. And by the way, the color that I put before, which is a black color, is called Spirit Rock, just in case you guys were wondering. Now I'm taking my all-time favorite, this is my first drugstore product ever that I used, and this is my CoverGirl Clean Normal Skin Foundation, and this one is in 125 Buff Beige. I'm just gonna use my NYX brush, and I got this brush, it goes with the Total Dry Foundation from NYX, but I'm just using this for this one because I actually really love how it looks with this foundation.
and just blend it out in circular motions. That's what I basically do. Sometimes I even dab, like if it was a beauty sponge, whatever works for you. But I feel like this leaves my skin very, very soft, so soft and so flawless. So that's what I'm doing. And then I just applied more, but the other foundation that I just applied right now, I added the LA Girl foundation, which you guys know that's my best foundation. And again, it's drugstore, so that is what I'm applying all over, just to have a darker, more of a color. And here, as you guys can see the background, my son was moving the curtain because I put him on the bed. And guys, don't worry, he was perfectly fine, because I know most of you guys are going to be talking crap, but he's fine. He was just moving it, and as you guys can see in the video, there's like a cable there, don't worry about it. He did not put it in his mouth, he was just trying to grab it, but he did not, because I kept pausing the video and just looking and just moving him. So he's fine. Okay, so you guys can see right here, I'm just using a black pencil, eyeliner pencil, whichever black pencil you have. It could be for the eye, for the lip, whatever, but just any black pencil. So I'm just using that. I'm just starting to just draw lines all over my face and just do triangles on top and on the bottom of my eye. So like on top of my eyebrow and the bottom of my eye, basically just triangles, and just color them in messily. Like I said, this look is very messy, and that's what I went for. So it's just very messy, because like I said, the whole makeup look is basically just that it's a girl that's dead but also pretty alive, so half dead, get me? So yeah, so that's what I'm doing here, just adding black. And that's what basically you do, just, you know, go with the roll with it and just start adding more lines. As you guys can see in the video, you will see what I'm talking about. Here I'm just adding a MAC lipstick, which is in golden brown, I believe. And again, as I said, this is a glam look, so we're gonna be adding some highlight to our cheekbones and everywhere, basically, just to give the girl like glam, because like I said, it's half dead but it's also half alive. So yeah, so we're just adding lots and lots of highlight to our face. So I just, out of nowhere, I just decided to add like this line to my lip, basically like a Frankenstein, and we're just adding that just because I think it gives it like a more, you know, definition, more dead looking. So that's what we're doing here, and I'm also carving out my lips with that black pencil as well. Now this was also a last minute thing, but I'm gonna go ahead and use the red color from the BH Cosmetics Smoky palette. I'm just gonna put that all over just to emphasize more the look, that it's more dead and just has bruises on the face. That's what I'm doing, and I think this really made the whole look come together even more. So that's what I'm doing, just putting all over, basically wherever you want your face to look like you're beat up. So that's what we're doing here. And I really liked how it came out. So like I said, you have to blend. And for this, I would definitely recommend to use a blending brush, just because it makes it look more like dead, more like your ass got beat up. And of course, we have to set our face, so we're using the NYX Matte Finishing Spray. Now it is time for hair time. So basically what we're going to do is just basically do two ponytails. And we're just going to go ahead and just try to make them not too even, because like I said, it's dead, so it doesn't really matter. And that's what we're basically doing here. Now this is my favorite, just because I'm gonna go ahead and add the red and purples to my neck, just to make a look as well, like my neck is bruised up and just dead looking. And I just did this last minute just because I think this will emphasize more the look and just make it really, really complete. So I really love this idea, and it just made the whole look way better. Here I decided to just do buns, just because I feel like the ponytails wasn't like dead looking alive, I don't know. And I just did messy buns, so that's what I'm doing here, just doing messy buns. And yeah, like you can do whatever hairstyle you want, but I prefer the buns, like messy buns. And that is all for this look, guys. It was very simple, just a lot of blending, a lot of colors. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, my first ever Halloween tutorial. Like I said, it was meant to be, you know, messy. That's how it's supposed to look. And yeah, so that is all for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you. Bye.